Morning. In the second lecture series, we are going to see the substitution methods. So, encryption methods can be divided into two types, substitution and transposition. So, substitution means in the plain text or the message, you'll be having group of letters. You are replacing some letters with some other letter means that is called as substitution. Substitution method can be divided into two other types, monoalphabetic and polyalphabetic. If you are considering one letter and replacing with another one single letter, that is called as monoalphabetic. So it is a one-to-one kind of relationship. Second type is polyalphabetic substitution. Here you take a single letter and you map it with more than one letters. So that is called that is one-to-many. That you call it as polyalphabetic. So the substitution methods, you are having many substitution techniques. The first one is Caesar-Cypher technique. Then you have monoalphabetic cipher, multiplicative cipher, affine cipher, Clafer cipher, Wignery cipher, autokey system, one-time pair, and Hill cipher. We'll be seeing with examples one by one. So first comes the additive cipher or shift cipher or Caesar cipher. This system was used by Julius Caesar King, and that is why it is called as Caesar cipher. Here, the plain text and cipher text. Should be within the residual class Z26. So already we saw the meaning for Z26. The numbers you use in this system must lie between 0 to 25. That is 26 minus 1, 25. So all the numbers must be from 0 to 25. If you are getting a number during your calculation more than 25, either 27 you are getting, you have to perform modulus operation and you have to bring it to Z26. Suppose in some calculation I am getting my answer is 27 means I have to perform 27 mod 26. So my answer will be 1 instead of 27. So that is the meaning of Z26. So here you will be having the plain text as message. The first step is you have to convert the message into a number with the help of the positional value. The positional value table is given here. So for A you have to replace with 0, B you have to replace with 1, C you have to replace with 2. It goes on like this, and for Y you have to replace with 25, and for Z you have to replace with 25. For Y it is 24 and Z it is 25. Based on this table, you have to convert the alphabets into numbers. This is the first step. Then you will be having a key. So the key will be a number from 1 to 25. With the help of the key, you have to perform this process. You have to add the plain text with the key and you have to perform modulus operation, that is modulus 26, if your answer exceeds 25. So this is the encryption process. Decryption processes, from the ciphertext you have to subtract the key. If you are getting a number out of the range 0 to 25, you have to perform mod 26. The key complexity for this method is 26. So we'll be so this is the diagrammatical representation. You are giving the plain text. You are adding the key with the plain text, the positional value of the plain text. If a record you take modulus 26, you'll be getting the ciphertext. So the ciphertext will be reaching the receiver. The receiver side will be performing decryption. You'll be subtracting the key from the ciphertext positional value. If record, you'll be performing modulus operation and you'll be retrieving your plain text. So this is the entire working of the Caesar cipher method. So here is an example. So using the Caesar cipher text, you are going to encrypt the plain text hello, and the key you are using is 15. So the first step is I am writing the positional value. For H, my positional value is 7. For E, the positional value is 4. For L, the positional value is 11. So here we are having the positional value table. First, you have to construct this positional value table. For A, you have to write 00, B 1, C 2, D 3, till Z25, you have to write the positional value. Referring this table, I am converting. And for O, it is 14. So I have completed my first step, that is plain text positional. The next one, I am writing the key below that. To find the ciphertext, I am adding. So 7 plus 15 gives me 22. 4 plus 15 gives me 19. So here 14 plus 15 gives me 29. So 29 is more than 26. So 29 mod 26, the remainder value will be 3. Instead of writing 29, I am writing 3. Only the range in the set 26 I have to write here. So now I have to do the reverse mapping. So 22 the value is W, and for 19 the value is T, and for 0 the value is A, and for 3 the value is D. I am writing the ciphertext. So this is my ciphertext. The encryption process is done. The next one is decryption process. The decryption process, now my ciphertext is WTAAD. I'm writing that. I'm writing the positional value using this table. Then I'm writing the key. Now I'm performing subtraction, 22 minus 15. Likewise. So here I'm getting 0. 0 minus 15, I'll be getting minus 15. So if you are taking minus 15 mod 26, you have to, for negative numbers, you have to subtract from the nearest multiple of 26. So for 15, the nearest multiple of 26 is 26 itself. So 26 minus 15, I'll be getting 11. So I'm getting 11, 14. I'm writing the positional value by seeing this table, and I'm getting back my original plain text, hello. So this is an example for encryption and decryption. The thing is, you're writing the plain text, then you're writing the positional value using the table, you're writing the key. You're adding the positional text, a plain text position with the key. Then your ciphertext is, the positional value of ciphertext is got. You have to write the corresponding alphabet. So that's all. The next one is, the next example what we are going to see is cryptanalyzing. Suppose you are given a ciphertext. So I am considering only the first example, CT1PHHWPH. This is my ciphertext. Now you have to cryptanalyze this to get the plain text. So in CISA cipher, the cryptanalysis method you use is brute force attack. Brute force attack means trial and error. Cryptanalysis means without having the key, without the knowledge of the sender and the receiver, you are supposed to find the plain text from the ciphertext. By some means, the intruder got the ciphertext alone. He doesn't know the plain text. So he is performing trial and error method, and he is trying to retrieve the plain text. So this is the text I am getting. This is not readable. So I am trying with the next. This is the text and it is not readable. So next I am trying with the key 2. I am taking 2 letters previous of P, that is N. Then 2 letters previous of H, that is F. Then 2 letters previous of W, that is U, and 2 letter again PH, it is NF. So 2 letters previously I am trying, I am not getting any readable message. So I am trying with the key 3. I am taking 3 letters previous of P, and 3 letters previous of H, 3 letters previous of W, and so on. And I am getting meet me. So this is a intelligible or a readable message. So this must be the plain text which the sender sent. So without the knowledge of the key, without the knowledge of the sender and the receiver, I am performing trial and error method, and I am finding the plain text. So this is the crypt analysis method of CISA cipher, right? Instead of thinking 2 letters previous, 3 letters previous, directly you can write ABCD in reverse. P means O-N-M-L. Then H means G-F-E-D. W means V-U-N. Or from bottom, you can write from top. It, either way, you can do. Whichever is easy for you, you can perform. This is the actual method. We are having some more examples also. The next method is monoalphabetic method. So monoalphabetic method is, you have to, the sender and the receiver will be previously having a table. So the table will be consisting of 26 columns and 2 rows. So here is an example. Here you are having A to Z 26. 26 columns you are having. This is your plain text. What will be the corresponding substitution letters? That is key. I'm shuffling and writing A, B, C to Z. So for A, I'm writing, randomly I'm writing L. For B, I'm writing R. C, I'm writing F. Like that, the sender and the receiver will be sitting together and they'll be forming a table like this. One thing you have to remember with this is in the key, you will be having A to Z exactly one time only. For example, if you are have for D, you are having V means in this row, you won't be having V any other time. Only here, you will be having V. Only one time, you will be having V. Only one time, you will be having H. Only one time, you will be having C. So, likewise, you are shuffling and writing the alphabets A to Z corresponding to the ordered arrangement of A to Z. This table will be shared between the sender and the receiver. So, how to perform encryption is, you have to just map, see this table and you have to write. For example, hello, I want to encrypt means, for H it is X. So, I have written. And for E it is Y. So, Y. Then for L it is D. So, D, D. And for O it is U. And so, I have written U. So, this is the ciphertext. To perform the decryption, you have to see the reverse. For X it will be, I'm finding X here, it will be H. For Y it will be E and it is here. So if you are doing the reverse thing, you will be getting the original plain text. That is the decryption process. This is the working of monoalphabetic cipher. The key complexity of monoalphabetic cipher is 26 factorial. So in all the combination, you can, if you want to perform trial and error, you have to perform it for 26 factorial times the maximum. So the disadvantage of this is, if you are having a good knowledge about the language, English language means, if you are knowing some clues in the English language means, you can be able to decrypt or you will be able to cryptanalyze this monoalphabetic cipher. For example, I am analyzing the frequencies, the maximum, I'm creating the frequency table. Always the probability of getting E is 12.7. So maximum I will be getting T for 9.1 time. So this is my frequency. I am constructing a frequency table. So E will be mostly occurred. T will be somewhat less frequently occurred than E and more frequently occurred than other letters. Like that I am performing the and I am constructing this frequency table. So with this frequency table and with the analysis of digrams and trigrams, I can guess the monoalphabetic cipher. For example, often repeated digrams are TH, HE, IN, AN, like that. Trigrams are the and her. These are the three letter words, was, which will be repeated again and again. So, if I am having a pattern AZR, so AZR is always repeating at the beginning means, it will be obviously or most probably it will be the. So likewise, with the help of this frequency table and the analysis of digrams and trigrams, I will be able to cryptanalyze this monoalphabetic cipher, and this is the disadvantage of this method. So the next one is multiplicative cipher. Multiplicative cipher is similar to additive cipher. So you will be having the plain text. First you have to write the positional value, then you will be given with the key. Instead of performing addition, you have to perform multiplication. So 7 into 7, 7 sevens are 49. It is out of 26. So 49 mod 26, you will be getting 23. Then for E, it is 4. 7 fours are 28. 28 mod 26 is 2. So likewise, you are multiplying, taking modulus 26, and you are performing the process means that is called as multiplicative cipher. Decryption is the reverse. You have to perform K inverse. Then affine cipher is the combination of multiplicative cipher and additive cipher. We are going to see only the encryption method. Decryption method, if you are having basic mathematical knowledge or cryptographic number system knowledge only, you will be able to perform the decryption. We are going to see just the encryption method. So encryption method is the plain text will be first, you will be having two keys K1 and K2. So first, you have to perform multiplication with the key K1, and then with that answer, you have to perform addition. Then finally, you will be getting the ciphertext. The decryption, you have to do the reverse. An example is the same hello I am taking. I am writing the positional value here. So the key is 7, 2. So 7 into 7 is 40. 49 plus 2 will be getting 51. So this is exceeding, 51 is exceeding 26. So mod 26 we are taking, you will be getting Z, and the positional value is 25. Likewise, 7 into 4, 28. 28 plus 2 is 30. 30 mod 26, you'll be getting 4. If you're executing the same process for all the letters and if you're writing the positional value, you'll be getting the cipher text. One important thing with affine cipher is that is the decryption processes. You have to take K1 inverse. And this will be different. So the key you're choosing must be only these 12 members. 1, 2, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 18, 19, 21, 23, 25. Because the inverse also should be in PZ26. Only these set of numbers will be having their inverses in PZ26. So when we are choosing the key, it must be only lying in this set. And the decryption process for affine cipher is out of the scope.